Well, hello everyone. Today's topic is the budget, this big document right here. And of course, we're still in COVID time. We're still in red restrictions as I record this. And certainly that has changed the way that we have to do a lot of things in society. And certainly the city of Brannan is no different. And we've just soldiered on, of course, doing our best to provide all of the services that we always provide to our citizens. And similarly, City Council will be deliberating on January 29th and 30th, the 2021 budget. Now, normally in that process, we have a public gathering, a public forum, usually here in City Hall, to present a few details of the budget and to gather input, answer questions from the public. As that is not possible to have that kind of in-person gathering, we did still want to find a forum for people to do so, and we've chosen this video format. So in a few minutes, you're going to hear from our acting city manager and, of course, city treasurer, Mr. Dean Hammond, who's going to give us a few outlines and details about this big document and what we can expect. And also to inform residents how you can submit your questions or observations or comments on an online forum that we are setting up. So council will still be as interested as ever from hearing the input of our residents, and we really appreciate you taking the time to do so. You could tune in on January 29th and 30th to watch the deliberation process as always, and certainly I know I could speak on behalf of all of council to say that we take this process extremely seriously. We consider it to be one of the biggest jobs of the year that we do on your behalf, and certainly with the COVID situation, the task will be as important as ever to do a great job of the budget, keeping any tax increases in line, because we know a lot of people certainly need the help. So thank you for tuning in, and thank you in advance for any input that you may have towards the 2021 budget.
Hello everyone, my name is Dean Hammond. I'm the city treasurer and currently the acting city manager for the city of Brannan. While it's unfortunate that we couldn't host our public budget forum in person this year, I am more than happy to present this video to provide you with some oversight of the city's 2021 proposed budget. The 2021 proposed budget sees an operating spend of $85.5 million, or an increase of $1.7 million for 2021. That is a 2.1% increase in spending over the previous year. In terms of how this spending is going to occur this year, we have seven different service buckets, the largest of which is protective services at 38.4% of the budget, followed by infrastructure at roughly 1/4, recreation, culture, parks, and youth at roughly 10% of the budget, support services at 8%, transit at 7.2%, growth, economic development, and housing initiatives at 6.4%, and sanitation and environment at 6.1% of the budget. In terms of where the revenues will come to cover the expenses, it should be noticed that in a municipal government, we are not allowed to incur a deficit, so revenues must match expenses. So on the bottom left corner of this pie, you'll notice that unconditional government transfers and conditional government transfers comprise roughly 1/4 of the revenues, followed by internally generated revenues, which includes user fees and sales of goods, other income, and permits, licensing, and fines at roughly another 0.25%. Of course, the remainder must be made up by property taxes. With this budget would comprise 56.8% of total revenues. It should be noticed that the 2.1% increase in spend is not equal to the proposed tax increase. While we are looking to incur $1.7 million in incremental spend this year, as I mentioned, revenues must match expenses. In terms of where the revenues will come from, we do have roughly $95,000 in incremental government grants from other levels of government. Our fees, permits, and other revenues are actually declining by approximately $360,000. A lot of this is due to the impacts of COVID-19 and the expected loss in revenues that will occur through 2021 because of those effects. With that, the remainder must be made up from tax revenues, and with the proposed $2 million increase in tax revenues, this is what would translate to a 3.15% tax increase for ratepayers in the city of Brandon. On the capital budget side, the proposed budget includes almost $66 million in capital spending. You'll note the different funding sources for this capital program, including debt at roughly $26 million. You'll note that we do fund a lot of our own projects through our own reserves, $20.5 million for general fund projects and $15 million for utility projects. And then the remainder is made up from incremental tax revenues and grants from other levels of government. In terms of what property owners can expect in terms of a tax increase, you'll note that the average assessed value of single family properties in the city of Brandon is roughly $270,000. With that assessed values in 2020, that would have meant a $1,900 municipal tax bill. Note that that is for municipal only, not the school division portion. And in 2021, with the proposed budget, this would see an increase of $60 with the proposed budget. When we talk about a municipal budget in the tens of millions of dollars, I always like to put it in perspective. So with this, I found this table very helpful. For a property that is going to experience that $1,960 municipal tax bill, this is what it breaks down to in terms of where the spending actually goes. I always like to break this down into a cost per day, which I find very helpful. So for perspective, our largest spending category, protective services, works out to roughly $2.06 per day, or roughly the cost of a cup of coffee to receive the benefit of protective services, i.e. police, fire, 911, and emergency management services. For more information on this year's budget, you will find all of the detailed budget reports on the city's website, as well as this presentation. If you're so inclined, there is lots of information there, but also on the city's website is a one-pager document, which gives a good overview of the budget. On this document, you will notice the seven different spending categories, as well as all of the different city departments that make up those categories. In addition to that, you will also note the city's full-time equivalent staff that are required to support those departments and the services they provide. In terms of next steps for the budget, council budget deliberations will occur on the weekend of January 29th and 30th. On the Friday, you can tune into YouTube to view the city's department heads presenting their budgets to City Council. And then on Saturday will be the actual budget deliberations. That concludes my presentation. I hope you have found this information helpful, and thank you for your interest in the city's 2021 proposed budget.